Okay, I just wanted to show you guys in case you wanted to get a snapshot of your three different graded sizes all in one file, like one snapshot. You can do it in CLO, or you can save them individually and put them together in a different file. But I just wanted to show you if you really wanted them in all open at the same time in CLO, you can do it. So what you do, you just save them as individual projects, basically. So I've already saved, this is size 10. I actually already saved a size 14 version. I'm going to go ahead and create a size 6 version. So I'll double click on the size to change the avatar to be size 6. And then I'm going to use the automatic grading tool. Let's click that once, say okay. And then it should resize this, and you can see the POI measurements will change. Okay, I like to then hit simulate to make sure there's no funny business. And then you just say file. Don't hit save because it'll save on top of your file. So you really want to do save as. And I'll just say project. And instead of size 10 sloper, it's going to be size 6 sloper. And remember where you saved it. Okay. So I think at this point, I can maybe minimize that library, minimize some of this. Let's just make our 3D screen pretty big. And I believe all you have to do is just say file import add. Oh no, file add. There we are. Project. So right now it's size 6, so I believe I would add size 10. It'd be the Z project. I'm gonna click that guy. Okay, where do you want it? I believe we don't really want, let's see here, let me find the right. I think this is where it's going to set it. So Z is okay at 0, but I think maybe on the X we should scoot her like over to the side. Okay, I think it's in meters, so I'm not very familiar with that. I'm going to try a 1. Oh, do I want to say, oh, object? I'm going to say, yeah, avatar. I think let's try this. Okay, yeah, one was good. And now let's try importing the third one. So we would say add project. The last one was size 14. I'll say open. Garment and avatar, yes, we're adding it. This time, instead of one, let's do negative one. So it'll be on the other side. So my only thing is I kind of wish I put them in order where this is 14 and then I wish I could switch these two because this is 10 and a 6. So I wish like the smallest was on the end and 10 was in the middle. Maybe there's a way to do it. I don't know. I think it's just faster to close it and redo it, to be honest with you. But here you go. That way we could try doing a snapshot possibly. Let's see what happens. That's just what it would be. And we have our multi. Oh, wow. Let's try that one. There we go. Yeah. So you can get all three of them in there, fill out the settings however you would want. I'll just say save. The only problem is that we are in CLO. These are really large files, and it could probably slow down your computer. CLO does have this cool software program that is free. We just go to CLO3D. com, their website, and if you scroll all the way down, you can choose download. Let me close those little windows. And then under download, we have some versions, but here is CLO Viewer. This is free, so if you're trying to send this to a customer or client, they don't have 3D software. They can download this. Now, unfortunately, for some reason, my computer will not allow it right now. My Mac has had some updates and they're being more picky about what I download from the internet. I'll show you what happens. I did actually install it already. Let me show you what happens. CLO Viewer, I'm gonna double click it. It's I don't know. It doesn't know if it's malicious software or not. So it's asking for CLO to actually update it. So that's kind of annoying. That's a new problem I've run into. But if your computer can get around it, it is kind of neat. You still do the same thing that I did in the actual CLO software where you go, you can start with file open and then you can do add project. And then it's neat because in the software, the person looking at it, they can rotate just by holding the right button on their mouse. They're not going to be able to make changes to it or anything like that. But it is kind of a cool view instead of just like a 2D CAD. It's like a 3D file that they can like actually look at. So that's pretty neat, and that's something you can save and send out if you wanted to. But just wanted to share that with you guys.